is called as eutrophication. Eutrophication means the substance having a more nutrients or enriched nutrients are present. Those enriched nutrients are suitable for the growth of plant and killing of animals. The loss of biodiversity is called as eutrophication process. And next one is killing of herbs. The killing of herbs is called as herbicide. The killing of herbs is called as herbicide. And the killing of fungi species is called as fungicide. The killing of pest is called as pesticide. So different types of fertilizers, herbicide, fungicide, pesticides are used for killing of microorganisms. So whenever this amount is increases, it causes water pollution. And next one is green chemistry. Green chemistry. Nowadays, the most important and advanced technology we are applied in green chemistry, and most of the research papers or most of the scientists are doing a research on in this topic, that is green chemistry. This green chemistry is used in nowadays in different fields, but now I am considering only some short field, only few types or few examples. This green chemistry is act as, one is bleaching of paper or organic purpose, organic synthetic reagent. And next one is bleaching of cloth. Clothes. So bleaching of paper. So that paper is bleached or cleaned by, we use some different types of organic solvents like hydrogen peroxide. This hydrogen peroxide means the chlorine gas. The chlorine gas is passed through a calcium hydroxide. It produces a bleaching agent. And next one is bleaching of cloth. This bleaching of cloth, generally we use for this purpose, the bleaching of cloth we use tetrafluoroethane. We use tetrafluoroethane is act as a cleansing agent or cleaning action of cloth. But this tetrafluoroethylene is causes a more dangerous effect on human being. Due to that purpose, we use another cleansing agent, the halogenated. The halogens are passed through a solvent in liquid ammonia, that is used as a secondary agent in bleaching of cloth. It is also cause damages, but these damage is very less when compared to tetrafluoroethylene. But nowadays for bleaching of cloth we use hydrogen peroxide. This does not cause any defects. So this is your green chemistry. Generally For bleaching of cloth inside, starting we use tetrafluoroethylene. It causes more side effects. And chlorine in presence of liquid ammonia causes very less side effects compared to first one. But nowadays hydrogen peroxide is not causes any side effects. That is your green chemistry. So environment is safe. And next one is organic synthetic reagent. Means ethylene molecule is undergoes oxidation in presence of palladium 2 or copper 2 complexes. In presence of these catalysts, it is directly converted to aldehyde. This is a direct process. Means ethylene molecule undergoes oxidation in presence of palladium or copper 2 complex. So means in this state, that catalyst oxidation state is plus 2. It gives acetaldehyde. This is a direct preparation method by using green chemistry. So these are the pollutant we are discussed. That is troposphere pollutant, stratosphere pollutant. So those two are pollutant for air pollution. Here three significant factors. One is air, water, soil. Air pollutant are troposphere pollutant and stratosphere pollutant. Water pollutant are pathogens, organic waste materials or alkali metals. Whenever the metal concentration increases in water, like sewage water or ground water or lake water, so it causes also some side effects. So that is your organic waste. And next, soil pollution. So soil also polluted due to some chemicals. So what are the chemicals are coming from the industries? Those chemicals are mixed here. It causes some side effects. And after that, green chemistry. This green chemistry is advanced one. So this is used in various fields. I am considering only some few. One is bleaching of paper, organic synthetic reagent, and bleaching of cloth. In this bleaching of cloth, the chlorofluorocarbons are, means CF2, double bond CF2. We use, after, but nowadays we use hydrogen peroxide. These are the pollutants. So most important one is this one, ozone. Ozone and oxygen. In between the oxygen, double bond is present. But ozone is containing triple bond, two are pi bond, one is sigma bond. That ozone gas is present in stratosphere. Oxygen is present in a troposphere around the atmosphere. This ozone layer is undergoes depletion, produces radicals. This is the preparation method of ozone.